We're going to explore downstream from where I started. I hope I don't sink. Let's continue downstream. The drop gets steeper and steeper the further down we go, so it speeds up. when I started off this taking the video, I grabbed an emergency poncho from the car, thinking that I need to keep myself dry. Problem is, I'm getting wet from the inside. This humidity is high and the temperature is still high. Usually I trim a video on YouTube as short as possible without losing anything out of it. I pretty much think that to enjoy this experience as much as I am, you want to see all of it. So I'm going to put this video is probably going to be a little bit longer. Now it starts to drop down into the gorge, and now it's picking up speed. The volume seems less. Well, it looks like it's dropped slightly, but not much yet, looking at the high tide mark. But because the speed's picking up, the volume will appear less. Stop, let's continue to hump to the gorge. See how far into it I can get safely. Now it drops into the gorge. I probably need to get closer to the right hand side, otherwise I might find myself on a small peninsula. So I'm gonna cross over to the side. There are more side streams coming in from other directions. Some loose boulders, some big loose boulders around here. Look at that. I see my way open. There's a small waterfall coming from the side, but I see my way open to walk along here and to reach far enough so that we can see most of the waterfall. So this is where the river run enters the gorge. Afrikaans, ons praat ons van 'n rivier loop, hierdie rivier loop nie, hy hardloop. Actually praat ons van 'n droë loop in hierdie geval. It's not a riverbed, it only has water in it when it rains, and then within an hour after the rains it will be 90% dried up. Soft sand, sinking in a little bit. Look at that. Look at this little waterfall. Just coming out of a dry desert mountain. This is where it drops down into the gorge. If you look at the video where I walked up the dry riverbed, I'll link to it in the end of this video, then you will see that I walked past this point And then you'll know that down there are some nice drops, but I'm not going to risk walking along this steep slope, slippery rock. So this is where I'm going to stop, unfortunately. I hope you've enjoyed the walk as much as I did, the exploring, the adventure. I hope you could hear that. That was a boulder rolling down under the water. I think if we're quick, we might even see where it runs out the bottom of the mountain. Maybe. Quite a bit of a walk back. But maybe there will be some light left over. And some water left over. It's starting to drop very quickly now. So I'm hoping everybody enjoys this. I can particularly smell the desert lavender. I think this is the desert. No, that's not the desert lavender. The desert lavender is makes a small white flower that usually grows in the side of the rocks. And it's got a very nice smell, and I'm smelling it now. This is it. This is the desert lavender. Oh, got a very strong but a very pleasant smell. You just have to touch the leaves. Very, very nice desert lavender. It's gonna make a nice big bush with a lot of small white flowers. Oh, very nice. Look at these boulders. Just some loose boulders. The sun is coming out. Oh, this was one, and then it got split open. This is about a quarter of the water that was flowing down here about 10 minutes ago. These flash floods are vicious, but they are over so quickly. But that also means that there's never a reason to try and cross a flowing stream in a dry riverbed. There's no reason to do it. You wait half an hour and it's going to be dry and you can drive through it. Even the level has dropped down as low. Low enough that you can walk through it. You still have those waves. No, firm. Firm, firm. That's firm. No, lucky, we're lucky this time, it's firm. Rainbow. The last little bit of the stream still flowing. It has lost most of its power. So this is 45 minutes about after I started going downstream. And gee, there's almost no water left. Another 20 minutes and it will be a small trickle of water. This is less than an hour from that, from when it started, and it's almost nothing already. That's it for this video. See you on the next one. Cheers. So I might still have some trouble getting home tonight. The FJ is not gonna get me home tonight. Still flowing. So that's not really an option.